Some of you have probably heard me say that print medium is dead, and I'm a firm believer in that for the most part. I don't believe in newspapers. I'm not a big fan of magazines anymore. I'm probably going to end up getting a Kindle or an iPad this year, so not a big fan of printed medium, but I wanted to share with you one. I still subscribe to a handful of magazines. I refer to them as my crapper content because I read them on the toilet, but Wired Magazine. I've been getting this magazine for like since the first issue came out, I've been getting this magazine. I don't think I've ever missed an issue. And in fact, one of the highlights of my business career was when they wrote one of my startups up in Wired. I was pretty excited. That's another story. In this month's issue, there's a really big article about Google's algorithm, and it's called Inside the Box. And there's a cover page for it. Anyway, I highly recommend you go pick this up. It's this latest issue of Wired. There's also a really good article in here about how money flows online. But I want to share with you a couple of things that I pulled out of this Google algorithm article, because it's an interview with Google's engineers. It's not, some guesswork article like most of the pieces that you find online when they talk about Google's algorithm. This is straight from the horse. So it's good information. The number one thing that I picked up from this is a prediction that I made last year, and if you follow my blog, you'll probably remember me making this prediction, that Google is going to start to lower link popularity ranking against social media presence. So when your link is mentioned on Twitter by someone who has a lot of followers, whether it's put through a shortener or not, it's irrelevant. It's going to get more ranking on Google when that happens. And Google knows the difference between automated Twitter accounts and bots and all that other kind of stuff. So if you think you're gonna cheat the system early, forget it. They're already ahead of the game. So you need to make sure that you're putting out really good content that people want to spread. And the more you do that, the better you're gonna do on Google. The number two I'm gonna share with you out of this article that I pulled out of this is that we have a lot of SEO clients that work with us, and one of the biggest struggles we've had to deal with over the last year or so is, a client will call me and they'll say, "Why is it that I'm number five on my browser, but when I go to work, I'm number two?" Or, and they're getting all these different results. Or I call my friend and I'm on page two, but I'm on page one, and why is that happening? And we used to guess. Well, we think it's because you're logged in and he's not, or we think it's because you're pulling from a different data center that's got a newer update or an older update than yours, and all these other things. What I found out is that Google is constantly testing upwards of 200 new integrations into their algorithm at any given time. And so what they're doing is they're using 60% of Google as the control group. It uses the standard algorithm, and at any given time, 40% of the user base on Google, which could easily be you or me any given day, is in a guinea pig test stage where our results are being calibrated or calculated against how long we stay on their website and how quickly we click through or how many times we re-enter a search to get to the right results. They're using all that data as a way to find out whether or not these new changes to the algorithm are worth propagating into their main database. So whenever you see a different result, and this is a really big thing for us because now we finally know the answer. If you see a different result to your friend or if you're a client of mine and you see a different result to what I see, it's because one of us or both of us is a guinea pig on Google's algorithm, and they're testing some new search feature, and so that's a bit of an eye opener for me anyway to know that about Google. It's a 4-page article. There's a lot more information. I'm not going to share it all with you because I'm a firm believer in supporting good content. Wired is a great magazine. I think you should pick it up. So that's all I have to say about Google's algorithm and Wired Magazine.